Dear learners, welcome on behalf of Indira Gandhi National Open University. I welcome you all in the B.Ed program of IGNOU. I am going to present you that what all main components are there in our B.Ed program. I hope that this discussion will help you in developing your understanding about our B.Ed program. Our B.Ed program is a two-year open and distance learning program which aims to develop an understanding of teaching learning process at secondary and senior secondary level. Dear learners, in our B.Ed program, we focus on enabling you as a student teacher to reflect critically on different perspectives of education, and our B.Ed program integrates holistically the theory and practices to facilitate your active engagement for knowledge creation. We have certain program objectives. Our main program objectives are: we focus for developing an understanding of the context of education in contemporary Indian society. You know, education is changing day by day. The role of education, the expectations of the society from education are changing. So our focus is basically to develop your understanding about it. We also focus for creating a sensitivity among you about the linguistic diversity in the classroom and its role in teaching learning process. As a teacher, when you will go to your class, you may find different types of languages and language diversity in your classroom. So how a teacher can be sensitive about it, towards it? This is also the focus of our program. We also focus on developing an understanding of the paradigm shifts and conceptualizing the disciplinary knowledge in school curriculum, and in identifying, challenging, overcoming the gender inequalities in the school, classroom, curricula, textbook, and social institutions. Our program enables you to acquire necessary competencies for organizing learning experiences and develop competencies among you to select and use appropriate assessment strategies for facilitating learning. Dear learners, our B.Ed program engages you with yourself, with child, with community, and with the school to establish a close connection between different curricular areas. And we also try to enable you to integrate and apply ICT to facilitate the teaching learning process in school management. We also focus systematizing experiences, and we also try to strengthen the professional competencies of yours as a student teachers. And also we provide you first-hand experience of the school activities through engaging you as interns in different secondary and senior secondary schools. Now the question comes, what is the duration of our program? Our B.Ed program is of 2 year duration. So minimum 2 years you need to spend to complete the program. But being an open and distance learning course, we provide you maximum duration of 5 years, which means if you miss any activity, any theory paper, any practical component in 1 year, you can complete it in next year, so that you can complete all the theory paper, all the practical components in maximum 5 year duration. Now there is no grace period. So if you will fail to complete all your components within 5 years, you will not be given any opportunity to complete your B.Ed program. Dear learners, we offer our B.Ed program in two languages. One is Hindi and another is English. Our all study materials, audio video programs, assignments are available in Hindi and English. Even during the term end examination, you can write either in Hindi or in English as per your choice. Let's see what the program structure is. In first year, we basically offer you 5 core courses, 2 content-based methodology courses, meaning the subject teaching courses, 1 workshop of 4 credit, 1 EPC course 1 and EPC course 2, 2 courses of 4 credit, and internship of 4 weeks of 4 credit. In the second year, we offer you 12 credit core course. There are 4 core courses of 12 credit, then one optional course of 4 credit, then one workshop of 4 credit, and two EPC courses of 2 credit each, so 4 credit, and the internship of 12 credit. So in first year and second year, you have to complete minimum 72 credits for the successful completion of our B.Ed program. Let us see what are the core courses in first year. In first year, we offer 5 core courses: childhood and growing up, contemporary India and education, learning and teaching. These 3 courses are of 4 credit each. Then language across curriculum and understanding discipline and subjects are of 2 credit each. So total 16 credit of core courses. Then we offer 5 content-based methodology courses: pedagogy of science, pedagogy of social science, pedagogy of mathematics, pedagogy of English, and pedagogy of Hindi. So any 2 course you can opt. You can opt pedagogy of science and mathematics, you can opt pedagogy of social science and English, you can opt pedagogy of English and Hindi, you can opt even pedagogy of English or pedagogy of mathematics. So any 2 courses you need to opt in the first year. And in first year, there are few practical courses. The first practical component is the workshop, which is a 12 days duration, so 4 credit. Then there are 2 EPC courses: reading and reflecting on the text and application of ICT, each of 2 credit, and one internship of 4 credit. In second year, we offer you 4 courses of 12 credit as core courses. These courses are knowledge in curriculum, assessment for learning, creating an inclusive school, gender, school and society. The initial 2 courses are of 4 credit each, and rest 2 courses are of 2 credit each. Then we offer one optional course. So we are offering right now 3 courses: open and distance education, guidance and counseling, information and communication technology. You need to opt any one course out of these. And again, in second year, there is a workshop of 4 credit. There are 2 EPC courses: drama and art in education, understanding the self and yoga, each of 2 credit worth, and one course is internship 2, which is of 12 credit, and it is of 16 weeks duration. So our instructional system, how we offer our course, how we facilitate your learning. We facilitate your learning through print self-learning material, which is our main medium. Nowadays, our self-learning material is available in e-form also through our e-gyan course and our e-content app. Then we provide you audio-video programs on various curricular and co-curricular topics. The topics which are covered in the workshop, we have developed a lot of audio video programs which will facilitate you. Then we give you assignments which you need to complete in each theory course. Then there are counseling sessions at your program study centers where your counselors resolve your queries related to each course. Then there are practical work in the school during the internship and the workshops at your program study centers. So these are the core components of our instructional system in B.Ed program. Assignment, as I told you, are compulsory component. One assignment you need to complete for each theory course. These assignments are to be submitted at the concerned program study center as per submission schedule. Generally, if you are going to appear in the December term end examination, then you need to submit your assignment before 30th September of that year. Here I also want to clarify you that if you are appearing, for example, in the December 2020 for your term end examination, so you need to write the assignment which are for 2020 batch available at your program study center, from where you can obtain them or you can download them from our IGNOU website. In the practicals, basically held either at internship school and our program study centers. We have 3 types of practical components: EPC courses, internships, and workshops. But before telling you about the practical components, let me tell you that we never entertain any request to change the internship school, study center, or regional center for the completion of internship component. So the study center which have been allotted to you, the regional center under which you have taken the admission, will remain the same. You have to ensure that you complete all the activities of internship 1 and 2 at a government recognized upper primary, secondary, or senior secondary school which you will select at the time of admission counseling, and it should be compulsorily within the jurisdiction of the study center allotted to you and the regional center where you are taking your admission. The internship. Internship is of total 20 weeks duration, 4 weeks in first year and 16 weeks in second year. So in these internships, you need to work as full-time teacher at the internship school which is selected by you. And the principal of the school and the mentors and observers appointed by the regional center or the study center basically supervise you there what you are doing. Then the EPC courses, there are 4 courses, 2 in first year, 2 in second year. There are activities suggested in each course. Some activities you need to complete at your internship school, whereas some activities you need to complete during the workshop. And assessment is based on the reports of these activities because there is no term end examination for EPC courses. Then there are workshops, 2 practical workshops of 12 days duration in each year, that is total 24 days. The workshop basically include intensive face-to-face interaction to develop skills and competencies among you. And these workshops are being organized at your program study center. Then the evaluation. For the theory courses, you will find some self-evaluative exercises or check your progress, which are in your study material. We never credit them, we never grade them, but they are for your self-evaluation. To assignment in each theory courses, which are a part of continuous evaluation, and in each theory courses, the weightage of assignment is 30% and the weightage of term end examination for each theory course is 70%. For practical courses, we basically do the continuous assessment of the activities at the school during the internship by your mentors. Then the assessment of the portfolio of the activities which you prepare during the internship and submit during the workshop by the workshop in charges. And also the assessment of the activities related to EPC which you have completed during the internship and workshop at the workshops, and your performance in the workshops. All this is being done by your study center in charge or the workshop facilitator. We also do your assessment during the internship by a teacher educator which we appoint through our regional center or school or study center. Please note that at least D grade is essential to get separately in assignment and theory, but the overall combination for each course should be C. If you miss any term end examination in or 1 year, you can appear it again in the subsequent term end examination, and this facility is available only up to the 5 years of the date from your registration. We basically follow the later grade system, so A, B, C, D and E grades are being given to you. We never give marks. This is the table which is showing you that which grade reflects your position at what level. If you complete all theory courses and practical courses separately with C grade, only then you will be declared as successful teacher. Now comes whom to contact. At the internship school, which is your work center, you need to contact to the principal and mentor where you will do your internship 1 and internship 2 and all the activities related to EPC. Whereas at Program Study Center, which is a teacher training college, there will be counseling sessions, academic counselor will take, there will be assignments, program in charges will be taking care of that, and the workshop-based activities where workshop facilitator will help you. So dear learners, if you need more clarification about the basic structure of your B.Ed program, please feel free to write to the mail ID soe@ignou.ac.in. I hope this discussion will give you a brief idea about the B.Ed program. Thank you. Thank you very much.